Hello friends, today we are talking about the information security triad. We all are aware that it is confidentiality, integrity and availability. But there are so many other dimensions of confidentiality, integrity and availability. Hardly we get in any other elaboration or explanation. So along with this CIA triad, today we are going to talk about the other aspects, conditions of or dimensions of the confidentiality, integrity and availability. But first we'll try to understand what is confidentiality. When we are talking about confidentiality, means keeping the information safe or confidential from the unauthorized users, or if in positive sense, if you are going to talk about that, so disclosure of information should take place only to the authorized users. Okay. The second aspect of information security triad is integrity. When we are talking about integrity, integrity talks about the correctness and completeness. There are two important elements of integrity: correctness and completeness. We'll discuss later on about that. But precisely, the manipulation of information should take place by authorized users and in an authorized manner. Then we are talking about that integrity is there. The third thing is the third dimension of triad is information security triad is availability. Availability means information or resources should be made available to the intended user when and wherever promised. Okay. And also it talks about that the limitations should not be there. According to the time frame it should be given. So there are other aspects or dimensions of this information security triad. Now we will discuss about that. There are eight dimensions of the confidentiality or the other aspects of the confidentiality. The first one is the sensitivity. The sensitivity talks about the quality of information. If the that quality of information is going to be damaged or disclosed, then there will be harm to the organization or to the enterprise. So this is one of the dimension of the confidentiality where there is need to maintain the sensitivity or maintain the quality of the information. The second one is the discretion. The discretion talks about that the user, whenever it senses that there is a probability or there are chance of disclosure of information, so can use his discretion to protect the information from disclosure. The third aspect is the criticality. The criticality is the how much, what is the level of criticality that depends upon the organization's classification. Now, if you'll see the operational aspect of the enterprise, you will find that the more level or higher level of criticality is required for the operations purpose. So according to the criticality of the information, the controls are required to be put in place. Okay. Coming to the fourth dimension, the fourth dimension is the concealment. When we are talking about concealment, concealment means hiding the information or preventing from the disclosure. One more aspect come in concealment is the security through the obscurity. However, when we are talking about the obscurity is not a valid concept of the information security, but in certain circumstances it also going to work. The next concept is the secrecy. Secrecy means keeping something secret and secret from the unauthorized users or preventing the disclosure of the information. The next aspect is the privacy. Privacy in today's scenario is a hot cake, and most of the governments also they are enacting and discussing about that. GDPR is one of the of that. Here in India also we are getting the personal data protection bill. So privacy is the protecting the disclosure of personally identifiable information. So that is also known as a PII. The next aspect is the seclusion. When we are talking about seclusion, means we are talking about storing the information in and out of the way, and there the whatever the level of protection required, that is there. Okay. And the last but not least dimension of or aspect of the information security triad confidentiality is the isolation. When we are talking about isolation, means the act of keeping something different from others. You can take the example of the internet banking in the banks. That web server is kept in a different demilitarized zone. So what we have done, according to criticality, we are going to segment it, and you are going to isolate those servers or those information or those processing centers. These are the eight different dimensions of the confidentiality. Now we are coming to the integrity. When we are talking about integrity, precisely three dimension is there. The first one is that authorized subject, we have to prevent unauthorized subject from modification of the information. That is the first one. Second one is preventing authorized subjects to modify to unauthorized modification of information. Okay, and third one is maintaining internal and external consistency. So what is internal and external consistency? Internal consistency is that it is true to the all interfaces which is there in the internal interfaces. And third one is it is also true to the external world or in comparison to the external world. Okay. Now coming to the different aspect of the integrity, the first one is the accuracy. Accuracy is talks about the correctness and preciseness. The information should be precise and correct. The second one is the truthfulness. Being a true reflection of the reality means it should be comparable or should establish the resemblance with the real world. The next one is the authenticity. And that authenticity refers to the genuineness of the information. Now, when we are talking about the next, the fourth aspect or dimension of the integrity is the validity. What is validity? That it is verifiable or factually or logically you can establish that yes, it is valid. The next aspect is known as a non-repudiation, and for non-repudiation you need to establish the that uniqueness, or you have to establish that in such a way that the user or the person who has accomplished the activity cannot deny that one. Okay, so not being able to deny, that is known as a non-repudiation. The next one is the accountability, and for establishing accountability, the non-repudiation is one of the important dimension. Without establishing the non-repudiation, we cannot establish the accountability. And when we are talking about accountability, means you are going to pinpoint a single individual for any act or for any transaction. The next one is the responsible. Responsible means someone or something is going to be given charge of or control of something or someone. So that is the responsibility. Completeness. Completeness talks about that all needed necessary component or parts are there inside that. Whatever the necessary components or parts are there in that information, that is there. And the last one, the 10th dimension or aspect of the integrity is comprehensiveness. Comprehensiveness means it is complete in a scope. Whatever the defined scope is there, it is complete. All everything is included into that. Whatever the needed elements were there, all that has been included into that. Now coming to the third arm of the information security triad, that is the availability. There are three other concepts or the dimensions of the availability is there. One is the usability. So usability means it should be usable to easily the user is going to understand and control the information and can use that one. So that is the state of being easy to use or able to understand and control. Okay. The next one is the accessibility. Accessibility relates to the assurance that whatever the widest range of the subjects or the large number of subjects they are going to access the information. So they should be able to access that one without any limitation. Whatever the defined scope is there, according to that, they should be able to do that one. And the third concept or the other concept of the availability is the timeliness. So in the beginning itself, I told what is availability, that the information or the system or resources should be available when and wherever promised. So when we are talking about timeliness, we are talking about that within the reasonable time frame, whatever expectation is there by the user or whatever promise is given to the user, according to that it should be available. So this is all about the information security track, confidentiality, availability and integrity. And also we have covered the other aspects or the dimension or concepts of the information security track. Hope this is going to suffice the purpose. Please write your comments in the comment box. If any further information required, that also you can put into the comment box, and we'll try to come up with another video. Thank you.